What we're going to do is have him play the game, and we will make a kind of a cameo review of our own work.
Okay.
And hopefully he likes it, because if he doesn't, that's going to be really bad. You know, every single Platinum game ends... Why does every game that we make start with destroying a city?
確かに考えたら、プラチナゲームズの作品、必ず冒頭、街壊してますよね。
まあ、そう。
バンキシとか、
ベオトゥルとか。The Destructicons, we got, there we go, we got Megatron. So I, like, it's funny, because I saved this, like, once I found out that you guys were going to get to play, and, you know, I have not touched this game, but obviously a lot of us have watched, we've actually had a couple people talk about Starscream, and then, so it's going to be super interesting to see how this ends up. And I think it's going to be funny that he's actually going to do a review of this. So.
まあ、あの、神谷さんのレビューは期待してるんですよね。あの、これはね、まあ、みんな、あの、プラチナゲームズがこれをプレイするってすごいどういうことになるって期待してて、まあ、楽しみです。
レビューってそれは素晴らしいゲームですよ。
Yeah. He's going to start the review by saying, this is an amazing game.
So the first question that we've actually gotten is, Kamiya-san, do you have a favorite Transformer?
一番好きなトランスフォーマーってありますか？
オプティマスプライム。
Oh, yeah.
あの、おもちゃが、1万円のおもちゃが出たやつは買った。
He bought the masterpiece version of Prime when it came out a couple years ago. Actually, more than a few years
okay,
ago.
Okay, so we got that, Optimus Prime. Okay, I don't even know if... I don't even know what that question is.
Hold on.
Is there a better Dragon movie than Dragon Slayer? I've never seen that movie.
Yeah, neither have I.
So yes, there is, because we've never seen it. So the answer to your question is there is a better Dragon movie.
Dragon Slayer という映画見たことはありません。Yeah, me neither.
なんだその意見。あ、そうか、ドラゴンにかけて
るのか。I will say though, my favorite Dragon movie would probably be Reign of Fire.
Oh yeah, with Matthew McConaughey?
Yeah, and yeah. Christian Bale's in that too.
Yep. Yeah, so we're saying that yes, Matthew McConaughey, and then Southbound just got blocked. No, that guy just got blocked because that was a terrible question. Oh, he's saying Dragon Slayer is a classic 1981 movie that we should go rent. So you guys should go. We'll get that high on your list, right? Like, that's right up there with finishing Scalebound and watching this movie.
Yeah. I love it when people call a movie classic and then nobody's seen it. It's like, dude, it's a classic.
It's a classic to you. So there we go. So Optimus Prime, here we go.
All right.
A jump,
eh? All right, so there's a jump. And he can show, oh, that's how he shoots.
Oh, and you're already in low energy. So I guess you need...
And that's dodge.
And now you're out of, now he's out of energy.
All right, so he's figuring it out.
Yeah.
He's like, I'm out of bullets already? Really?
There's a lot of bullets. But in the
middle, there's a lot of bullets.
He's like, limited ammo. Who thought of that?
Somebody did ask in the question of, how did Scalebound come about? Because I mean, people are talking about Dragon movies. Where did the idea for Scalebound come from?
Scalebound のきっかけは何でしたか？
まあ、単純にドラゴンとか恐竜とか好きで、あの、そういう最初は恐竜を自由に操るゲームを作ろうというところから始まって、今、どんどん発展していくうちにこうアイデアがドラゴンになっていった。
So, Kamiya-san really loves dragons and dinosaurs and things like that. And actually, way back in the day, we had a prototype that was kind of dinosaurs doing their own things. And as you know, we started the prototype and restarted the prototype and canceled the prototype and all that kind of iteration, we ended up with dragons. Flying around doing really lots of cool things. And that's how we kind of came up with Scalebound. I mean, the idea is to put dragons on screen and make them do really cool things.
So, there you go. He likes dragons and dinosaurs. And it turned from dinosaurs into dragons.
X がジャック攻撃、
Y が
強。
So they want to know, obviously, because we're playing the Transformers game, and he liked dinosaurs. Did he like the Dinobots?
Dinobots 好きでしたか
？Dinobots
あの恐竜のトランスフォーマーズ。
ああ、そこはもう俺世代じゃないと思う。
Yeah, so he basically is only OG Transformers.
Oh, okay.
And when they started getting the Dinobites and all the other Transformers, it's not my era.
There you go.
Which means that he watched like the first two episodes of Transformers and was like, yeah, I'm good. あ、また弾切れですよ。He's out of bullets again.
ちょっとどうするの？
So it's like we some do like a why why
why. あ、もうない。いたたたた。ちょっと待って。どうすればいいの？
そこは頑張る。
So somebody ask.
そんな硬くない。
Will Scalebound have crazy combos and epic boss fights like Bayonetta? Is that the question that we're asking?
Yeah, I don't know.
Can we? Well, it's not like Bayonetta in that, you know, you're not going to... まあちょっとお仕事中なんで、ベオらしくコンボ出るんですか、Scalebound で僕答えましょうか。So, I just let him know what the question is. We get that question a lot.
Oh, okay.
It's not like Bayonetta where the idea is that, you know, you live and die on a single frame. Right? Like you have to basically your frame counting in Bayonetta and how good you are depends on how well that timing goes. It's a little bit more cerebral, right? Okay. So the idea is how do you make awesome combos and how do you do cool things with your dragon? Right? So it's not about, oh my god, I need to be worried about this one frame. It's more about understanding where you are in relation to your dragon, understanding what your dragon is doing, and then playing off of each other. So the craziness isn't from like really twitch button response, although the button response is actually really good.
Right.
The craziness comes from combining what you're doing with you and your dragon. So
got it. Okay.
Like we were doing a playtest today, and basically the dragon and I, instead of fighting together, kind of went off and did our own things, but kind of like started overlapping like this through the course and ebb and flow of battle. Like, oh, he needs help. Let me go help him. Oh, let's go do something cool. And then like that ebb and flow is really, really cool. And when you understand that and start feeling that, like, it doesn't have to be Twitch to be crazy.
Got it.
It's kind of what we think.
Okay. Somebody wanted to know, are there any influences from Monster Hunter in regards to gameplay, monster combat, and any fighting?
スケールバンドではモンハンの影響とか受けたりしてるんですか、戦闘部分とか遊び部分とか。
モンハン俺遊んだことないんで。
So, and Kamiya-san says this with full certainty because he didn't play this game either. He's never played Monster Hunter.
So any similarities were purely...
Yeah, purely coincidental.
Yes. Okay.
Tell the lawyers.
Tell the lawyers. People are saying this game is beautiful.
Ah, Transformers, kirei tte yutteru n desu ne.
Inaba-san, thanks you for that.
He wanted to know. He said, what do you hope people will feel when playing Scalebound?
Nice. 質問ですけど、Scalebound をプレイしながらユーザーはどういうことを感じてほしいんですか？
まあ例えばゲームが苦手な人でも、そのベオみたいなあのハイスピードのアクションゲームが苦手な人でも、プレイヤーがうまくこう戦えなくても自分の相棒のドラゴンが敵を倒してくれるので、その迫力を味わうだけでも楽しめるのかなっていうふうに思います。
まあその絆の部分を味わえてほしい。
まあそのもう一人自分の相棒がいるからこう寂しくないよというか怖くないよっていうことを。
The idea that we really want people to feel is that they're never fighting alone.
So
no matter like how good or how bad it's going for you, you've always got this amazing dragon that's there to back you up and support you and stay with you while you're fighting. So the idea that you're never fighting alone is really important to us, and we really want people to understand that.
Okay, awesome. So many people asked about giveaways. Yes, and we actually do have some giveaways.
We have swag.
We have swag, and you guys brought really good swag. So we have like signed, well that's what I've been told.
Okay.
We got signed posters.
Wait up, they don't get to see the swag until we're over 10 grand.
Oh, is that what it is?
Yeah. Okay. I think we should keep the swag on
Here's what I was thinking, JP.
All right.
So we can do the posters. I'm saying if people want the, because people are asking about the hoodies. If people want the hoodies,
yeah,
we got to get over $10,000 to give away the hoodies.
I'm okay with that.
Yeah. So we're gonna do it easily. What we got right here, right now, and I'm gonna have Frank, come on here for a second. Frank, I love Frank. He's awesome. He likes St. Louis, which I like St. Louis baseball fan. We have got these amazing signed Transformer posters.
If you die, you're blocked.
So here's the question: If Kamiya-san dies, does that mean he gives it a bad review?
No, if Kamiya-san dies, he blocks himself on Twitter. It might be the end of the universe, but you never know. He might.
I see him upping his game like all of a sudden. Like, yeah. He all of a sudden, it's like I see focus in Kamiya-san right now.
Yeah. The only thing that Kamiya-san hates more than bad questions on Twitter is losing at anything.
Oh!
C rank, this
year. Man.
He got a C rank. We'll give him a pass. What does the stream have to say about?
Yeah. So what does the stream have to say? We're giving away these posters. They're amazing. What do we got? Show the okay. Where? Show the game.
キャラ変わるんだ.
Let's see.
Damn, man, we can't please anybody. Show the game.
Can people see this?
Okay.
So anyway, we're giving these out. I want to see where we want confirmations at Crackdown and at Scalebound for the people who are going in there. I don't know why people are saying show the game. This is the game.
Yeah, no, I think that probably they're late. We might not have been showing the game there.
Yeah, so maybe for a second.
Were we not showing the game for a second?
There was a little bit of
Oh, it's all right, because that's when Kamiya almost died. He's probably happy that didn't...
Let's take that off screen.
Yeah, exactly. Oh, he wanted to... Yeah. Okay.
じゃあ、最初のデブステータス戦どうでしたか?
あ、もうちょろいもんだったね。
So people wanted to know, what does Kamiya think of the controller he's holding? It's got the grippy on the bottom. It's actually the Forza one.
これ、Forza の専用コントローラーですけど、
あ、そうなの?
下の部分がちょっと違うんですが、どうですか?コントローラーとして。
いや、全然持ちやすいよ。
Yeah, easy to hold. Feels good.
Yeah, okay, there you go. Yeah, I'm a big fan. It's got grippies unlike the normal ones. We're giving away one of those Forza custom controllers. Forza custom Xbox Ones.
Oh, wow.
So if you want to get one of those, this is, it's Kamiya Pro.
始まってんの?
始まってます。
汚ねえな、ちょっと。
He's like, wait, that cutscene's over? How did that start? That's not cool. And apparently, Inaba-san just told him, you don't actually have to fight that guy. Which is now
like...
So, yes, the posters are only for donators unless we hit $10,000 beforehand, and then we'll give some to the stream. We have a lot of posters, right? So they did a great job in terms of the posters we have, but these are, like JP was saying, these are super high-quality posters. And again, we got to remember, guys, this is for the kids. This is donations, right? So we're trying to raise money to get people on, to basically raise money for Extra Life and for kids in general. So... that's why we're giving them to donators. And so we'll go through these, and then we will do the Scalebound ones. We have our guys in the back tallying as they kind of come in.
Hopefully, I'm the first one to have made this joke. But like the Osiris and Wu Tang, these posters are for the kids.
One of the things that could come up: what is Kamiya's favorite modern game that isn't a platinum game?
Oh. Forza Horizon 2.
Forza Horizon 2.
Oh, man. Yes. Yes. That man, awesome. Yes. Forza Horizon 2.
My favorite game of last year, too, to be honest.
That game was... So this is to all the guys that turned 10. This is a big shout-out. That game is amazing.
We got to give props to Playground, though.
Yes.
You can't say turn 10 without Playground. Those guys got to get their props.
That is a great point. Ben, good friends with Ben. I went on tour with a lot of those guys when we did Sunset Overdrive. Mm-hmm. You're right. Playground Games. You guys have always been an amazing racing studio. It's great to see that coming out with Forza Horizon 2.
I love how... So usually... how this relationship on the couch works is that we do play checks of Scalebound, and Kamiya-san is telling Inaba-san how to play the game as we're like playing new features. And now the exact opposite is happening. Kamiya-san's playing this, and Inaba-san's like, "You gotta get top speed, man. You gotta get top speed, and then go hit him, like just like that."
So now, it's kind of like the Jedi, right? Like where he was the student. Now he is, basically, he is the master. Here we go.
Oh, Kamiya-san's figuring it out.
Hold on.
So one question that somebody did ask, and I don't even know the answer to this. Maybe you guys did. Where did the name Scalebound come from?
Where did the name Scalebound come from? Marketing? No.
That is a perfect answer. Okay.
No.
So,
JP. 怒られるね。
No, I'm not saying anything.
Not at all.
まあ、でも意味あるんですよね、うん、
まあやっぱりそのそのドラゴンの力で命を共有している二人の絆を表した名前ですね。
So, that actually does have, it didn't actually come from marketing, it came from somebody on the team. But when we were brainstorming names, we came up with this idea of, you know, the game has an enormous scale, right? But dragons also have scale. So, scale was kind of, you know, a really key word for the game. And then we thought about kind of the journey that Drew goes on in the game. And bound can mean multiple things as well.
Right, yep.
So when you think of all the meanings of scale and you think of all the meanings of bound and you think of all the meanings of both of those words put together and the different combinations of those meanings, it actually is a really good hint as to a lot of the things that happen in scale bound and what the gameplay and also the story is about and the core themes are about. So it actually is a name that fits really well.
Yeah, so there you go. That.
Actually, Frank, who came up with who is taking credit this week for coming up with Scalebound?
I was going to say, it's always the random team member that's taking credit.
Yeah, you know how like back when you're talking with like your high school friends and you've been out of school for ages.
Yes.
Somebody always takes credit for a story that they didn't actually come up with.
Yes.
Yeah, coming up with the name Scalebound is kind of like, you know.
How many months did we deliberate?
Yeah. Long enough.
trust me. So it's funny because we have a similar thing on Crackdown, and that's who invented agility orbs. And we get that, like, it's funny because we brought that up when we were interviewing Dave Jones.
So this segment right here, we've got this gameplay programmer, and his name is Inoue. But everybody, the kanji for that is also like donburi, which is like a rice bowl. So we call him Don-san. And he might be the most sadistic gameplay programmer on the planet. So whenever we test a game, in this particular segment, he basically coded all the enemies in Bayonetta and all the enemies in Devil May Cry and almost everything in this. And he stands behind you while you're playing a game, and every time an enemy hits you and you don't say it was cheap, he starts smiling like he's like won the lottery. And then the minute that you say something was cheap and he actually agrees with it, it's literally like he just gets angry with himself and he's like furiously scribbling notes. And then like 2 hours later, he's like, play it again. And you're playing it, he's like, it's fine now, isn't it? It's like you've insulted his manhood by calling anything that happens in one of those games cheap.
So, I mean, it's funny because, I mean, one of the things that in the Veganist is just platinum games are challenging, right? Like, I mean, what do you, like, when you guys figure out and you think about balance, like, what is, like, what, how frustrated do you want the player to be? I mean, I don't think I'm saying it correctly, but you know what I mean? Like, what's your thought? Like, are you thinking, like, this has to be challenging? Or, like, is that part of the gameplay mechanics that is a platinum game, so to speak?
これは稲葉さんと神谷さんに対する質問ですけど、こういうアクションゲームを作ると難易度の調整はどんな感じで調整するんですか？なんか難しく したいのか。
違うんだよ。これね、ずっとやってるともうゲームがどんどん上手くなってきちゃって、これ簡単すぎるんじゃないのって言って、もうちょっと難しくした方がいいかな、もうちょっと難しくした方がいいかなって、バンバンバンバン難しくなっていくパターンなんだ。
で、プロデューサーに激怒されて、ふざけんなって。
So the way it works is, as you're building a game,you know, the things that start out hard start getting easier and easier.
Right.
And so the creators of a game will start making things harder and harder and harder and harder.
Right.
And then the producers on the game will start playing the game that they keep making harder and harder and harder and be like, why is this so hard? And the producers will start bringing it down.
Right.
And kind of that collision of both people, like the designers wanting to make it harder because they're used to it and the producers being like, what are you doing? Make this easier. Usually finds a really good balance point.
Okay, awesome.
返信どうやって解けばいいんだ?
They want to know, here's a great question. How did the three of you meet?
解けないよ。
How did the... Well, we didn't meet at the same time.
Yes.
So,
what's the story of, like, how you guys all got to, like...
稲葉さんと神谷さんがどうやって出会いましたか?
どうやって出会ったか? それは彼はもともとカプコンにいて、俺がカプコンに転職して入ったっていうのがきっかけで。
So Inaba-san met Kamiya-san because Kamiya-san was already at Capcom. So Kamiya-san joined Capcom out of school, and he had left a different developer and came to Capcom, and that's how they first met.
で、後にデビルメイクライナルプロジェクトに俺が配属されてっていう。
And then, so when Devil May Cry got started, Inaba was assigned to the project, and that's how they got to meet each other personally. And then I met Inaba-san and Kamiya-san at the same time, which was I was right out of college and joined Capcom in localization and was working on Clover Games.
Okay.
So
yep,
the
yep.
first, actually, Beautiful Joe on the three or on the DS.
Okay.
Was the first game that I ever worked on, and he wrote some of the script, and Inaba-san was obviously the producer and head of Clover, so I met them that way.
Okay. So when they like, so the question is that with the three of you guys, what made you decide, like, how did you guys decide that making games was your like the thing you wanted to do?
なんでゲームを作りたかったんですか。
なんで、もうゲーム、やっぱり、ゲームが大好きだったから。
神谷さんの答えは非常にシンプルです、私はゲームを好きです。稲
葉さんは？俺もそうだ、子供の頃にゲームに出会って、もうこれを一生の仕事にしようと決めたから、子供って。
Yeah. And so, Inaba-san, when he was a kid, just decided that I'm going to make games for a living, it's what I'm going to do. And I was the same way. I think I was 5 or 6. When I decided that I wanted to make games, I had a little spurt after watching the first Jurassic Park when I wanted to be a geneticist. But other than that, it's always been games.
That's awesome. And then, so the other thing too is, what was your first? Like, so you talked about your first, which was it Beautiful Joe on DS?
Oh, first game.
First game you ever worked on and shipped.
Okay. あの一番最初に関わってて発売されたタイトルは何ですか。
一番最初に関わったのはアメリカで売ってるのかな、あの謎魔界村っていう、あのインクレディブルトゥーンズのキャラクターを魔界村のキャラクターに変えた、あのプレイステーションとサターンで出たゲームがあるんだけど、それ初めてやった仕事。
The first game that he ever got his name into the credits and shipped was 謎魔界村。 So I guess I don't think it came out in the West. It's Quiz Ghosts and Goblins or something. And okay. It's like the Incredible Toons characters where they had the Nozzle game got reskinned with all the Ghosts and Goblins characters.
Okay.
And yeah, there's lots of little games like that back from that era. Inaba-san, 一番
俺はあれ、あの最初がアイレムだから R タイプの最後の R タイプレオっていうアーケードの最後
の
最初。 So, and Inaba was working at Iron, the shooter developer. So, he worked on the last R type arcade game.
Oh, yes.
R type Neo or Leo?
Leo.
R type Leo.
Okay. And then how did Platinum Games basically come about? From like, so they worked at Capcom, then is there a cool story behind this Platinum?
It's
or?
A complicated story. I know. Platinum Games を作ってた理由と、
それはどういう、稲葉が、あの、反乱を起こして、
いや、これ、あの、流れてるんで、やめてください。誰でも見れるんだから。
He was like, this is live, isn't it? You're not allowed to say what he just said. That will stay untranslated for the sake of all of our salaries.
なんで作ったとか、まあいいじゃない。みんなプラチナのゲームが遊べるからそれでいいじゃない。
稲葉があの会社に初めて。
So Inaba-san said that he started Platinum Games so everyone could play Platinum Games.
稲葉が初めて会社に入ってきて、で、あの、そう、カプコンに入ってきて、で、一緒に飲み行った時にあったの。あの、上司と一緒に。あの稲葉の歓迎会って言って、その歓迎会の席で上司に向かって、僕は将来カプコンやめて自分で会社立ち上げますみたいなことを言ってたんです。
So apparently there was a dinner way back in the Capcom days that Inaba-san invited Kamiya-san to go to, and it was them and all of the kind of higher ups at Capcom at the time. And he looked at all these guys at the dinner table that are all his bosses at Capcom. Inaba-san's like, "You guys do know that one day I'm going to quit and start my own company to make my own games, right?" Can you imagine being like going to dinner with Phil and being like, "Phil, man, it's going great. By the way,
I'm gonna go.
You know, I'm out in a while. We're gonna be making games."
No, I could not imagine that. But that's ballsy right there.
Yeah,
that's awesome. Okay, so some of the we got some other questions up here.
How we doing on
You know what? It's funny. Let me find out. Well, let's see how we're doing on giveaways and money raising and all that sort
yeah,
of stuff.
Yeah, because you can't fail us, guys. Like, for the sake of Bayonetta, you can't fail us.
Yeah, you cannot fail us, right? Like, we are like we got them.
Actually, you know what? Let's put it on a little bit harder. You guys can't fail the kids.
Yeah. Oh wow.
You can't fail the kids. I'm going there. I'm owning it too. You guys can't fail the kids.
You can't fail the kids. You heard it here first.
Oh, nice. Megatron got out of there real quick. By the way, Kamiya-san might be driving this Lamborghini as slow as like, he's grandma slow with this.
Oh, except for when he hits the wall, yeah? So guys, we are getting donations. We have raised another $150, but we are still a long way from, we're $100 closer, but we need 700 more. These guys, like, I think Kamiya-san will cry if we don't raise the money.
あと700ドル残ってるんですけど、たどり着くかな？1万ドル。これ何？こっち本当に。 We've lost him to him to driving Miss Daisy.
反対だねこれ。あの分かれ道を右に行かなあかんねや。
Should we put on Forza Horizon 2 instead? Would that help him? I mean, sorry, yeah, Horizon 2.
難しいならホライズン2に聞かれるんですけどね。フォルザホライズンだったらな、今すごかったのにな。
He's like, I do love Forza Horizon.
So he's been playing now for 30 minutes. Like, is he still up on the game? Like on our Kami review, we haven't gotten any much in the Kami
review.
This
is an amazing game.
1本と言わず2本3本とぜひご家庭を揃えていただきたいですね。So,
not saying that you need to buy multiple copies, but if your retailer has multiple copies on the shelf,
you should buy multiple copies.
Yeah. It might not be for the kids, but it could be for your kids. Christmas, stuffers, available now.
There you go. So far, right now, Transformers Devastation has the Kamiya seal of approval. I think one of the things we can do is develop a sticker for that. And then we might actually have to have him come try Crackdown 3 and see if we'll do it. And we'll develop a similar system, like the whole Nintendo one, remember, where it was like we had the Nintendo seal of approval.
Okay.
And we'll just do inter-game seal of approval.
All right. I'm gonna back this up with my wallet if I have to. But if anybody watching the stream has been blocked by Kamiya and donates, guaranteeing an unblock. Yes!
Oh my gosh. Okay, guys, that is huge. He says yes.
Okay. I know. Kamiya-san, I'm going to tell him what I just said. Kamiya-san, I just
Does he want us to take a picture of this fail screen with him in front of him?
Ah, oh, もう fail block ですよね。 まあいいわ。 I think he's really confused as to what's going on. あの、募金してるんじゃないですか。まあお金出したらブロックされてる人はアンブロック強制的にブロックさせますよっていうことを言いましたけど、それでいいんですよね。そんなお金
We will unblock for the kids. You guys hear
it for the kids.
Like, I think this is actually a pretty massive thing. Yeah. Like people, like there are other people here around the stream right now who are literally in shock by the offer in which that has been put. So if you donated and you are blocked by Kamiya-san, he will unblock you for the kids.
Yeah, but you tag me on Twitter if you're doing that, because like I'll actually have to go through his block list and help him unblock you.
So you have to tag. And your Twitter is
PG_JP. Yeah.
Okay, so PG_JP. You heard it here. Tweet him proof of donation. He will look through the block list. If you donate now, consider yourself unblocked. For the kids. I kind of feel like I should tweet Kamiya to get blocked. So then I have to donate, but I'm going to see if other people are. We got Southbound who says that he better get on that. So we got some people who are.
ブロックされてる人はいるんでお金出すらしいんですよ. He's like, they're surprised that people actually, there are blocked people on the stream who are actually going to. Thank you.
Yeah, thank
you. For the kids.
For the kids.
More trade.
So there are like, actually, there's quite a few people because we were like, I forgot if I was blocked. And then like, people are like, oh man.
That says something about the quality of the people on the stream and at the same time. Like, wow.
So some people were asking, and just like given Transformers, was there other cartoons, anime, other things that he did? Like, did he enjoy cartoons or videos like this, or was he is he more into Walking Dead?
Kamiya-san, anime, suki deshita ka? Kou iu robot kei no
anime to ka? Ah, ore wa, ma, totoeba Gundam to ka.
He's a huge
Gundam fan. Motto sakanobore wa Mazinga Z to ka geta.
So like Getter and Mazinger Z and the first season of Gundam are huge, huge touchstones for him. He loves those.
Okay.
まあ、プラチナがね、ガンダムゲーム作ったらね、とんでもなくすごいものができるよ。
And he would like, he would like to, since we're on a live public stream, like to declare that if Platinum ever makes a Gundam game, it's gonna be badass.
Yeah, I, you know, the other thing, and I am all for that, if he could also do the same thing with a Macross game, that would also be good.
Macross のゲームも同じように、
かっこよく作ってくださいよっていう。
Yeah, they're like, yeah. No, I will say one thing, like, looking at this, it's really cool that we got to make a Transformers game. I so want to make a G.I. Joe game.
That would be awesome.
Wouldn't that be cool?
That would be cool.
But you know what the greatest thing about a G.I. Joe game would be? And I'd have to do this, like, this would have to be the way that you make it, right? Everybody would shoot like stormtroopers. Because you can't actually shoot anybody
right,
unless they're holding something.
But they're all really using laser guns anyway.
Yeah, yeah, but like in G.I. Joe, if you shoot at somebody, the only way that shot can ever actually hit is if they're holding something that can ricochet out of their hand. Or you can blow up as many fighter jets as you want. As long as that little parachute comes out afterwards, right? So, like, it wouldn't be, like, could you imagine multiplayer in a G.I. Joe game? Like, if you made it true to the cartoon, it wouldn't be your kill-to-death ratio. It would be your hands shot out of guns, your hand, guns shot out of your hands ratio.
And then you have, like, you would never die. That would be the other thing, too.
Oh, yeah, you would never die. And I guess, like, a kill streak could be, you know, calling in the twins to annoy you.
Yes, that is true. By the way, we're starting to get other requests for Platinum games. we've got a request for G.I. Joe.
Okay, あの作ってほしいゲームのリクエスト. まあ僕は G.I. Joe 作りたいんで、それは僕が言っちゃった。
So we got G.I. Joe. G.I. Joe. Crazy lightsaber game for Star Wars.
あの Star Wars.
Metal Gear.
Yeah, we're okay with Star Wars. Yes. Yeah, we're down with that. あの lightsaber main ね.
Metal Slug.
Metal Slug.
And somebody there has been actually been quite a few people said Gundam.
Yeah, Gundam would be good. I'll say Vanquish too, just to get everybody
He-Man.
Talking again. He-Man.
Like, we're just basically, it's up to Platinum to bring back all of the 80s cartoons.
I know, He-Man. He-Man, Masters of the Universe. とか.
あれ、日本流行ってなかったんですね。
いいもん、知らない。
Yeah, that didn't show up in Japan, so I think that might be a really awkward one.
Yeah, so that would be weird for them.
Yeah, a little bit.
Okay, so, but I mean, everybody is agreeing that if you guys make these games, the ones that have been recommended, that you guys would, they would basically buy them, or multiple copies, as he said.
Yes, for the kids.
For the kids.
For the kids.
Okay, so let's see. Let's check on the. We've said some for the kids. Let's see if Kamiya unblocking on Twitter. If that's
happening.
If that's moving the needle.
Actually, I'm gonna.
You're gonna have to check Twitter.
Yeah, I'm checking Twitter.
So unblock 応募が効いてるかどうか。
Because I mean, this is your one chance. I think beyond this, like, I don't think he would unblock. I don't think he would unblock people.
Oh, so so.
I don't know.
Well, money is going up. Like, we are getting money. It's weird because it doesn't show the. It won't show that the total takes a little while to move, but we are definitely getting, like, I'm watching our money continue to go up.
That's cool.
So we are getting donations. Let's see how many we have gotten. Oh yeah, look at that. See, extra life, extra life, extra life.
Oh wow, sweet.
So 10, 5, 10, 10. There's a 25. We got another 15. So yeah, so we're getting donations, guys. We are getting closer. We don't know how much closer. Any unblock requests?
Not yet. Although somebody. Actually, Inaba is the one who said that he was going to leave and start his own company, Grenade Man.
Okay. And then,
Constructicons.
The next one that's come up is Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, they said.
Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, that would be kind of cool.
That, I mean, like, the thing is that that is, I mean, an animation, like the old school animation like this would be awesome.
Yeah, that would be neat.
Some guy said that, oh yeah, people, oh, Power Rangers.
Power Rangers.
Man, you guys have basically started like,
oh,
he's like, would Power Rangers really be a good game? Oh, I'm going to go with a deep cut, Silverhawks.
I don't know what that is.
Right? Exactly, yeah. That's why it's a deep cut.
Yeah, that's right? Like...
And it'll be like the toys, like to do anything in the game, you'll have to pull both triggers, like squeezing the legs together so the wings pop out. Like,
so by the way, so one thing that they did say, and they're asking on here, is it, if Kamiya-san likes Forza Horizon 2, where is the Platinum Racing game?
Yeah, Kamiya-san ga Forza Horizon 好きなら、なんでプラチーナがレーシングゲーム作れないんですか？
I think
we like playing those.
Oh,
I don't know if we really want to make.
I can't tell if they're actually excited about it or he's mulling it over.
Oh, I think that you got a resound. That was the polite now.
Oh, okay.
that was the slow cap reaction to us making a risk.
So how do you know when you get like a hell? Oh, well, I guess I don't know.
Special attack.
They said Thundercats.
Thundercats? Oh. Yeah, that would be kind of cool. I'll show you what the difference between. Racing game is not good. Gundam no game.
Oh, yeah.
That's the difference.
Okay.
Oh.
Oh, nice. And while we're doing this, I just want to give a special shout out to Doc Cupcake. Who raised $800 on his stream for Team Crackdown. And that is amazing. So thank you very much, and congratulations on that. Oh, no one said kill la kill, say kill la kill. I wouldn't play that game, so there you go.
Speed Racer. Yeah, he's down for Speed Racer.
Well, yeah, that was a good yes.
Yeah.
So the thing is that it sounded like when I said Macross, that was like a bad, that was like a no.
That was a polite yes.
That was a polite
yes. I was like, no, we'd rather make Gundam.
Okay, got it.
Don't the doors in this game, those kind of breakable barriers, look a little like the old school Contra breakable barriers?
Yes, it does. It was funny because I was thinking very much the same thing. So another scale bound question.
Yeah.
He said, will Drew be able to call Thuban to him in midair?
Oh, you mean like this? That's going to be a conversation. Do you mean like grab him in midair?
Yeah, like wait, can we? We need more details.
Yeah.
From Mr. Truman.
Yes. Clarify the question.
You don't have a lot of time, guys. We have 8 minutes left till the end of our segment. This has been absolutely. Oh, he said there were question, and I'm a huge fan. Cowboy Bebop and the Big O. Like, where do they sit on those?
Cowboy Bebop. Cowboy Bebop, Kamiya-san's never watched it, so he's not sure.
Oh yeah. Oh, so given this, yeah, that would be a good one. Kamiya-san, after this is the turn 10 guys.
Ah, これが終わったらフォルサのチームが入るんですよ。
あ、そうなんだ。
So they would like to. They, now that they know that you're a huge. Forza fan, they want to meet you, just FYI.
So, I died. He's like, I'm shy. Do I really have to do that? Dude, they're right behind you. Yes, you have to do that.
Tell them they also want to know if you're available for Forza Horizon 3 as a developer.
Forza Horizon 3作ってくれませんかっていうことをちょっと話し合いたいらしいんで。
そうだね。
作りません。
いや、俺はいいかな。
Yeah. It's like, I don't think I could do that. I'm good.
Yeah, I'm good, yeah.
I'd rather play that one.
Okay. So
you know what they should do, though? I think Tuban should be a car in Forza Horizon.
Oh, man.
Tuban
no.
DLC, right? So like Ride the Dragon?
Yeah, so we got a lot of requests for Forza Horizon cars and Forza cars, because we're still waiting for a Crackdown car, which has been promised. We do need...
I'm not asking for
a livery.
Car.
You want...
I'm like there's going to be like McLarens and Lamborghinis, maybe a couple Ferraris, and then running right through the middle of them at full speed is going to be a dragon. I think that would be better.
That would be pretty awesome.
Yeah. I think I'm okay with that. He can occasionally fly if people think he's too slow.
If that's what it needs, but
right, like you know that first the first Horizon challenge where the you're racing the airplane, right?
Dude, that just flies up and fireballs awesome. Him. I think that would be.
No, see, that would be an awesome challenge if he was if, like instead of fighting a racing against a jet, you race against the dragon. So that would be good.
I know. Kamiya-san got lost and is now complaining about Kenji making this game in a way that he
okay, so has the rating gone down? Has the rating gone down?
素晴らしいゲームじゃなくなったんですか?
いや、素晴らしいですね。
It's still an amazing game.
But not no longer multiple copies.
でも、じゃあ、でも一本でいいって感じ? 数本…
いや、まあ、2本は買った方がいいんじゃないですかね。
Well, at the very least, you should still probably buy two copies just in case one breaks.
Oh man, that's awesome. Just okay, so we have races. We haven't had our ticker update. We do have people who are going to basically definitely get some posters, but I don't know if we're going to be able to give away hoodies, and we're okay with that because this is for the kids. But the one thing I want to say is there anything that Kami wants to say to the people watching for Extra Life, etc., like that, you know, basically comes to you, but like what is
もうそろそろですけど 最後の挨拶何か言いたいことありますか? あ、稲葉さんから
いや、俺から?じゃあ俺はトランスフォーマーぜひみんな2本ずつ買って 楽しんでください
あ、でも、2本以上は買わなくてもいい その残り余りの金額は子供へ
そうね、今日神スーパープレイを見て楽しんだっていう人はぜひ寄付をしていただければ
he died! Perfect place to stop, actually
僕の言ってる内容が台無し
So Inaba-san would like to say that please buy two copies of Transformers, but you don't need to buy more than two copies of Transformers, and any money that you were going to use to buy the multiple copies that he was suggesting, please give to the kids.
Give to the kids. Okay. Awesome. Well, I wanted to say...
Kamiya-san,
So, the only thing that Kamiya-san wants is for everybody to continue loving games. Any game, just keep loving games.